talk with Steve Rogers. He's a former lieutenant detective at the Nutley, New Jersey Police Department, also a former member of the Joint Terrorism Task Force. Steve, situation like this, kind of unusual in that the gunman was taken alive and apparently dropped his weapon. I mean, police didn't even have to fire a shot. What does that tell you?
It tells me that the El Paso Police Department, their training kicked in. What an excellent job they did. And I've been in active shooter training scenarios. And, you know, just think about this, John. You've got guns pointed at the killer, at the shooter. And you're thinking, you know what? We got to get this guy out, but let's get him out alive. You know why, John? Because your training tells you that what's in his mind are a lot of answers to questions that law enforcement will need answered as they move forward with the investigation. I believe on the scene they could have had a hostage negotiator with them, but some of those officers evidently talked this guy down and he surrendered.
And, you know, I mean, the adrenaline had to be pumping. Everything, you know, would be telling these guys, or, you know, perhaps women, you know, be ready to pull the trigger, and they didn't.
Well, again, when I go back to my years in law enforcement and we're on active shooter training scenarios, yes, your adrenaline's running. They didn't, because their training kicked in. Do everything you could to take a person alive. I mean, if you got to shoot them and take them out, that's one thing. But they did an excellent job.
Yeah, and for all of the, you know, New York City, we're seeing buckets of water thrown at police officers for all of the abuse that police take. This is an example of them absolutely behaving spectacularly and doing the best to protect all the rest of us.
Before I came into the studio, I talked to two New York City police officers outside, and I thanked them for their service and their job, and they looked at me and said, despite what you hear and see, we're going to do our job. We're going to protect the citizens in this city and around the country from violence.
All right, so this guy, whoever he is in custody right now and obviously being questioned. If you were in the interrogation room, what would you be asking him?
Question number one, was anyone with you? Did anyone drop you off? Are there any accomplices? That is critically important, John, because if there were one or two people connected to this shooting, then this was a planned shooting. That's very important. Question number two, you want to find out, again, a timeline. Where were you earlier? Who were you with? Who did you talk to? So those are very important questions as we move forward. And, of course, the search warrants are now being executed as we speak to his home, his computer equipment, et cetera.
Now, we heard from the attorney general, and again, this is preliminary. The attorney general seemed to suggest that he had not had this verified, but he believed that the shooter was from the Dallas area, who then apparently traveled to El Paso for this awful thing. Does that have any particular significance to you?
Well, one thing, and I've mentioned throughout the day, that it's very important that no one speculates on these things. The commander on the ground who has all the information should be the person giving all this information out. John, we've heard so many reports. Multiple casualties, no multiple casualties. Multiple shooters, no multiple shooters. We learned earlier someone said it was an AK-47. How do we know that? You know, so I would caution people just to wait for the commander on the ground to give the information, and that is where you're going to get that accurate intelligence.
And the chances of it being an AK-47 are actually pretty slim. That's an Eastern European weapon and not commonly found in the United States.
Very slim. The purpose of information is to calm the temperatures down, let people know we got everything handled, calm down, and wait to hear from us again.
All right. Thanks very much, Steve Rogers. We'll be talking to you more as the evening progresses. Thank you.
Thank you.
On the phone.